So we're with our friend John Danner from Danner Constrictors. He let us come down and check out his awesome collection. He has a bunch of really cool artwork and cool stuff on the walls, and we're going to show you guys. So he has some really cool animals that are stuff that we don't normally keep, so stay tuned. We have in here? I see a big bulge there.
Big jungle carpet.
Big jungle carpet. Oh my goodness, it is big.
It's a big one.
It's a big one.
So Ben, put your face in there for scale.
Like outside of it? Or
it's... No, in. Right next to it.
You don't have to pull him out. I know you said he just ate, but he is big. He's pretty.
He is. He's not mean. He's just, they have so much energy and they want to climb everything. So if you take him out as the arboreal, he's going to try and rip everything off the walls to climb it.
Mm-hmm.
Take him outside, he tries to get right up the trees. And the birds all dive on him. You put him in the bird.
So you say he's 15 years old?
He's about that.
Pretty good.
About a yearling when I got him.
It's pretty cool. Now it's messing with the luck.
He eats once a month, every 4 weeks.
It's cool, man.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Spike. I worked at a nursery near my parents' house when I was 14 years old for a couple weeks to get money. And I ordered them from Randley Turtle Farm over the internet and got them shipped. I got him and a soft shell turtle, a couple of map turtles at the time. He's the only one who's still around.
How old is he, you said?
He's about 19.
19 years.
Yep.
Pretty cool.
He ate a fish that big this morning.
That big. And you got lots of stuff down here.
Yeah. He's in a 300-gallon stock tank. I mean, it's a...
You don't have to pull him out.
I just lift him up a little. He's bigger than he looks.
Oh. They are big. That mouth says, place hand here. Cool, man.
It's funny, most of what he eats is the little Missouri turtle pellets. They're so tiny.
Oh, yeah.
I throw a scoop of them in there every night. That's almost all he eats when he gets that big. They think they did some dissections on dead ones down in Louisiana, where they're naturally from, and 60% of their stomach contents was acorns on some of them. They're big plant eaters. You wouldn't expect it, but.
I've never held a blood python before.
She's nice. Yeah. T positive.
Yeah, nice cherry head.
I just bought her mom from someone in Long Island.
Mm-hmm.
A lot smaller, but it's a true cherry head.
She is heavy.
Wow.
Yeah.
She's eating once a month, like extra large rats, whatever I'm buying for cheap from RKC.
Head looks like a leaf.
They're funny though, like they'll eat twice a week if you let them, but they get fatty liver disease.
So it's another point to know your animal.
Know your animal.
That's pretty cool.
She's the nicest one I have, as far as temperament.
Man. And you said you don't want to get into these?
She doesn't even strike to feed. You just throw the rat in there and she just eats it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
This is cool. Awesome animal.
I should actually have eggs for her next year.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
There you go. Only lady.
Their color changes too. Only had it for about, I don't know, 4 months.
Let's see how dark she is.
Oh yeah. Wow. That's like a hearty red wine.
Yeah, the guy was getting out of bloods. Bought her and a pair of the nicest T negatives I think I've ever seen. As far as redness goes.
Super cool.
This is your, what normal T neg would look like.
Wow.
That orangey color, that's a giant male. He's actually been for sale. I took him to Hamburg a few times. Keeps coming home. Everybody comes to the table to look at him and to hold him and everything else, and I don't really want to pull him out there. He won't bite whoever's holding him. I don't trust him with fast movements walking by him to not strike.
Right.
But that's, I mean, he's a nice looking snake, and then you get into, this is one of the ones I bought, that deep red T negative. It's just, wow. Like the red, they're actually red, not orange, and that's
really unusual. Pretty.
Those are some hardy snakes.
Dang. So the bullets on the bottom. He's in shit. It's a T positive. This is a T positive Baddock. She would be too, late winter. I'm gonna pair her with, pair this guy to her. This is a 007, so it's a golden eye matrix. It's 100% het T positive.
Oh, wow.
I got in last winter, it came from Gasper. Be pretty cool to mix the T positive, like to start working with the genes in the bloods, not just the regular morphs. Mix them together. I mean, there's not many people doing it with the blood pythons. Not on the East Coast, at least. Everything cool I have, I got shipped from across the country. This was the male T negative to pair with that female that I just picked up recently. Same thing, red.
Mm-hmm.
This is the only Borneo I have. Girl, marble Borneo. I gotta get her a boyfriend eventually. She only eats live, which is a pain, but still I feed her every 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
When they're smaller, I feed them weekly, and then when they get to about his size, it's 2 weeks, and the Baddock size, they're every 3 weeks. The big girls are every 4. They just, their metabolism's so slow. Like, they might go to the bathroom every 5-6 months, and it's like water bottles in there. But they'll overeat, and then they get fatty liver disease and die. This is supposed to be a male to pair with that big Sumatran I have, but he doesn't eat well. I've had him a year and a half already. He does eat, but he, frozen and live, he strikes it and kills it and then only eats it 50% of the time.
Okay.
Even frozen, he'll strike it, coil it, I'll walk away, come back 20 minutes later, he's not eating it, heat it up again, put it in there. He's just tried all different things. Keep trying with him.
And the black bloods are cool looking.
Yeah, he came from a hardened herp. He's got some nice blacks. That girl's deep in shit, the big black I have.
Wow, she's huge.
Yeah.
Wow.
I have another rack getting made now for her with the Christmas tree tubs. For all the three big ones are going in from Herptastic. It's actually a little behind. And another hatching rack I got from him too. That's all the bloods and short tails for now. Everything else is balls except for the jungle. He wouldn't expect that's what it looked like.
Mm-hmm.
With the fin in the center of it. It's big emu.
So you said that your buddy's tattoo shop closed and you bought a bunch of his oddities?
Yeah, I had a bunch and I bought everything he had. He had. The black cast hornbill. That's an articulated penguin on the bottom.
I thought it was a penguin, but I was like, that's weird.
Yeah. Doesn't quite balance right, so I stuck the rock under it. Top half of a human skull.
Man.
What do you got? Wet specimens. Deer. Fetal deer. Stillborn dog. Pitbull.
Huh.
is a neat collection.
Mm-hmm. So what's your favorite?
I don't know, I have to think about that.
Bobcat skulls.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, there's two of them.
The one, yeah. One's a lynx, one's a bobcat.
It's cool, man.
Yeah. This was actually a spur off one of my roosters.
Wow. You wanted me to catch one of those?
Yeah, this one got eaten by the coyote. Here's a spur off a big ball python. I was cleaning her cage, I found it. African porcupine quills. Way sharper than you would expect.
Oh yeah? Let's try it.
Wait.
You can't imagine getting hit by them.
It's a fun artwork.
Yeah.
Oddities.
A little deek-deek, dick-dick, whatever you want to call it. Smallest antelope.
Mm-hmm.
I was told this is a turkey vulture. My buddy found it in the woods.
Oh, nice.
I'm not positive that's what it is, but...
Got a heck of a beak on it if it's
yeah.
not.
Yeah. One of the top snakes I produced so far this year. She's gonna stay here. It's a Enchi Orange Dream GHI Yellow Belly.
Can I check it out?
Yep.
Enchi.
I like the squared off pattern on her. The Orange Dream just coming right up the sides.
Wow. That's gorgeous. It's a female, you said?
Yeah.
Man. Nice.
I have a GHI Enchi OD and a GHI OD Yellow Belly. They're both for sale, one male, one female. So it's three genes, not the four.
Hmm. Orange Dream looks nice in it.
It does. It's the Enchi in there that started to square off the pattern because the GHI Enchi OD is starting to square off. It's just the Yellow Belly really cleaned it up.
Got you. You don't see that combo very often.
No, I had a male from Oz that was either Yellow Belly or Asphalt. High intensity Orange Dream, Enchi, Yellow Belly or Asphalt. Proved that Yellow Belly. I threw him to a GHI Yellow Belly female this year. Got 8 eggs from a first time mom.
Oh, nice.
But I got ivories and not freeways. So. It wasn't Asphalt.
Yeah.
I was looking at Asphalts online last night. I have Highway, but I like the,
mm-hmm.
I like Highway to go pastel with it, and I like Asphalt to go Orange Dream with it, Enchi.
Cool, man.
Yeah. She's cool. These are her clutch mates. So this is, what I was saying, the Enchi started to square it off. This is a GHI Enchi Orange Dream. It doesn't have the Yellow Belly in it, but you can see it started to box off the pattern a little bit.
Wow.
That's a male.
And this is the female?
Yeah, I believe that's GHI Orange Dream Yellow Belly.
GHI Orange Dream Yellow Belly.
She doesn't look anything like my regular GHI Yellow Belly. My GHI Yellow Belly, the hatching was almost black, all the background in her. Now mm-hmm. she grayed out a lot as an adult, but as a baby she didn't look anything like that.
These are cool, man.
Yeah.
Get super GHI into it, that would be awesome.
That high intensity line from Oz is hard. It's different than normal Orange Dream stuff identifying it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a single gene that doesn't even look really Orange Dream, but it's got so much banding down the sides of it, you know something else is going on with it. It's
cool, man. That's gorgeous.
These are a pair of pastel candies
They're 100% het pied.
The light like glares off on there so bright.
Yeah, the female's gonna stay here, the male's gonna be for sale. I hatched a pastel Enchi candy het pied last year. So hopefully he'll go back to the ladies this year and I'll actually get some visuals.
It'll be interesting.
Yeah, I like the candy pie project. They're just, they're coloring up so much. You can really tell looking at that one's stomach in comparison. They're just, every day they get brighter. It's nuts. That when they hatched, they were just so much brighter than normal candies. The pastel's making them glow even more. Mm-hmm. And I don't really like pastel in a lot of combinations either, but it's working well. I think it'll work well with the pie as well.
Absolutely.
So.
Just a kiss.
Yeah.
Little one. Not sure why. Pastel GHI Mojave Clown. That's just ridiculous. There can't be a lot of these around.
No.
Like, I know people that have been working this project for a while and they're just producing GHI clowns.
Yeah.
Super GHI clowns. This is cool.
My buddy's friend out of Long Island did it. Same guy who made this spot nose clown. He sold all his collection, hundreds of snakes, and he keeps maybe 10 really high-end animals. He'll buy like, he just bought a highway clown. So that'll be
check out, next year. Can you see the head? This is really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about a powerhouse female. Man.
By the time she's ready to go, I should have some really good males coming from the spot nose to the pairings I've been throwing.
Yeah.
The heads. It's another one of my top snakes produced this year. It's a female Orange Dream Super Enchi Yellow Belly.
Man.
What'd you say her parents were?
It was a high intensity Orange Dream Enchi Yellow Belly to a Enchi Yellow Belly that I got off you guys.
my heart.
The head's just awesome. The whole snake's awesome. I mean, it's
orange flames.
She ate frozen thaw as soon as first feeding. No problem.
Nice.
Yeah. I usually do that. I'll try and feed everything frozen first.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like one in three will do it. If they don't strike, I'll leave it there overnight. And a lot of them will eat.
So, Super Enchi. We produced a clutch of, we think we got, what was it, Enchi Fire Infernos. And we're having a hard time because of like, the adding the fire and Enchi together kind of stretched out the pattern that we're used to being compressed.
Yeah.
But it made this huge like red orange flames on the side. And I'm like, I don't know. But seeing that, it like kind of can start to see how it loosens up the pattern. You just threw a fire energy woman there. You'd be
I threw that same male to a giant fire girl. So.
Oh yeah.
She should go still. She's like 3,500 grams.
Oh, wow.
Never laid.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Better give you 16 eggs.
Yeah.
Ryan, you want to get in here and take a look? So GHI Yellow Belly, so pretty. How like blush this is, but not black, which you would think it would be black. It's pretty cool how bright this is. Wow.
This is a double head from Oz that'll go next year. Double head candy pied.
Pastel Inchi double head candy pied. Candy is kind of like the recessive version of a banana, but they look a little bit different. They hold their color a little better, a little longer. They're pretty cool.
This was a Craigslist thing. She's not nice. Spied. Out of Atlantic City for $350. Already 800 grams when I got her.
Wow.
Good deal.
It's good to pick up stuff on, you know, like when people are getting out or like,
yeah,
you know, but we just caution people to always, or you know, quarantine. Might be the reason they're getting out of them is because they lost a whole bunch and they just can't deal with it anymore. Who knows? So, yeah.
This girl just laid this week. Pastel Super Stripe. Throw a pastel highway to her.
It's real cool, man.
Five eggs. First time mom.
That's great.
This so. She's in shed, but she's really cool looking. Orange Dream Super Stripe.
Even in shed, she looks awesome.
I mean, compared to this is a normal Super Stripe. She's just, she's brighter in shed than that one is normally.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
That's crazy.
I have a lot of yellow belly stuff.
So why do you use these water bowls?
Just easier for me to clean. I like taking the whole thing out of there, scrubbing it.
Mm-hmm.
I usually end up having to pull them twice a week.
Twice a week. We do the deli cups.
Yeah.
You know, so you dump them and toss them.
If they fill them with bedding, I'll pull them, because I go through these every day. I'll pull them and clean them that day. But I'll go through and pull them out of each rack on like assigned days. I'll fill buckets with the water bowls and go scrub them.
It's pretty cool. Banana pied. It's pretty cool. Very pretty, like banana patterns. So it's pretty cool to see just breaking away that pied gene there.
This is a hot snake here. Or the yellow belly head pied.
Wow. OD yellow belly head pied.
Works well together.
Yeah.
Kind of yellow. Tail here. It's crazy. It's like everything is outlined in bright yellow with all this dark in between. It's cool.
This guy. Pastel Highway. Looks color nicely. I've seen some that are really, they white out when they get older. They don't look nice.
What about this guy here?
The trick boy. I wasn't even supposed to be trick when I bought him.
Wow.
Black pastel banana trick.
I had to get a hold of the guy I bought him from because he was drawing such weird patterns. Because there's trick in there, I just didn't think it was in that animal. So, trick and black pastel can really be funky. Doesn't always show.
It's pretty cool. That's a really cool animal. It's like neon highlights all through. It's a cool animal.
Yeah, he's fathered a bunch of clutches for me. It's probably my oldest breeding male, longest one I've had.
Wow.
This girl only gave me 2 eggs this year, but banana leopard head clown.
Oh, banana leopard head clown. That's a fun one.
She's also 50% head pied, but I didn't try that out.
Cool. We have a lot of fun stuff.
See the blackhead, this blackhead Mojave Fire. The Dynasty.
Blackhead Mojave Fire. Man, that's a cool stripe. Wow. So that's a GHI Mojave Yellow Belly.
He was also sold as supposed to have been black pastel, but I haven't thrown any black pastels from him. So,
wow.
Those clutches. I only got one clutch from him this year. It was to an Inchi Mimosa.
Cool.
I was black pastel chocolate tricks.
Black Pastel Chocolate Tricks. I do like the chocolate gene.
The trick has greatly muted the pattern. I have two Black Pastel Chocolates in that rack. I can show you the difference in it.
Well, yeah, I mean, if we could hold them side by side, I'll hold one. And so, really like this. Mm. Kind of thinking about maybe picking one of these up, to be honest. But this is Black Pastel. You can kind of see how this is like kind of more of a tannish than it is yellow. And you got this black in here. Then the chocolate just makes everything darker. So you see this is a chocolate black pastel.
Yeah, without the
and
trick.
Everything is so dark. The trick really messes up the pattern here. You can see this craziness here, but also gives a lot of blushing in between where the chocolate is. Black pastel and chocolate just make it really dark, which is really, really cool. But the trick in here is just makes it, steps it up to that kind of the next level. You can see the big difference in the heads, how light this head is versus this one. It's really pretty patterns here, but this one's just so much brighter and the pattern just gets messed up so crazy.
Yeah, the trick brightens it a lot.
And here's a chocolate trick that all the way around. So you can see the black pastel made all the pattern just more coffee looking. I'm trying to think of a term that's not a genetic, but just the color is like a little bit more brown. This one, it's a little bit more normal of a color. So you see it's a little yellow, a little highlighted there. But then the chocolate makes it real dark. And then the trick pulls all these patterns out kind of wonky and adds this bit of blushing, whereas chocolate wouldn't do that. These are some cool snakes, man.
There's a male from the female, or from the male banana. Surprising.
We've hit that odds twice.
Well, I hit a female this year too.
We have yet to hit a female banana.
That black pastel banana is female.
Oh, black pastel banana.
Jeez. Really light.
When those colors start coming in, it's gonna be intense.
Yeah. Same thing though, like I've had these that you can tell their trick and ones that you don't know.
So that's what?
This is the Cheerio, he calls it. No. I just made that name. Go ahead, you can
It's talk. A vanilla trick.
Just vanilla trick.
That is crazy.
Look at this nuts pattern. Look at all these alien, they like added alien heads, just like stamped them all over the place. Is unbelievable.
I didn't expect that to come out at all. I have a black pastel vanilla trick too I saved.
Wow.
So this one is
black pastel vanilla trick.
Oh yeah, it's definitely much darker. Still has the rings.
Yep.
Man.
That's crazy.
The ring,
I like it.
The rings is the trick with the black pastel usually.
She's even shed it looks like, but
black pastel banana trick.
Black pastel banana trick. You can see these like rings and rings and rings and rings.
A lot of times with trick too and black pastel, I've noticed it's doing this pattern right along the back of the neck. Those dots. Mm-hmm. It's a trick trait. If I have a black pastel and I can't tell if it's trick or not, if it's got those, it's usually turning out to be trick.
That's awesome.
Which is banana chocolates.
Chocolate bananas, everybody loves. Get themselves a chocolate banana milkshake, that's right. And these are both males?
Both males. This one's actually black pastel as well.
Very typical of banana stuff there. It's really cool looking. Chocolate banana, and this is a black pastel banana?
Black pastel chocolate.
Oh, so this is a chocolate banana and a black pastel chocolate banana.
Yeah.
Wow. Man, I'd have... I mean, I can easily see the differences, but especially these little guy well, here and a couple...
You can look at the line, start to build them in the alien heads in between them.
Yeah.
And that was the black pastel throwing it in there.
Right, right.
Whereas the chocolate, all the chocolates I had don't have solid. That at all. They're solid.
Gotcha. Some pretty animals, man.
Thank you.
We are done at John's, and we've decided to go a little road herping. So we're in my Acura, and if you look at, you can look at the map here. We are now going off the map, and
off the map.
There are some people riding dirt bikes back here. We're just riding around some trails, you know. And
we're gonna get mugged by a bunch of teenagers.
So now we're just looking around for some animals of sorts that are just hanging out in the middle of the dirt path or on the street. So Ryan, you want to explain why this is a good time of the day?
So it's twilight, sun's going down, the animals are trying to soak up the last bit of heat.
Sun's going down, big guy.
What?
Give me your hand now.
So they'll come out and they'll hang out on road surfaces, you know, get the last bit of heat before the sun goes away. Some of your nocturnal reptiles will start to try to get a little feed on. So it's a good time. I don't know if we're gonna find anything because the dirt bikes came through, but we'll see.
So tell us what you're doing.
I'm gonna pick up some rotten moss covered hardwood.
No, to the camera. We're picking up some rotting
moss covered hardwood that we can give to our isopods. Look at this beauty. Oh yeah.
Oh look, a black widow.
That's a black widder. Thought it would break right there. That's some good wood.
We're driving around, I don't even know where we are. We're like lost in the woods. Don't touch my roof.
So this is what happens when you decide to go off-roading in an Acura. Actually, holding up pretty good.
It's because I'm an excellent driver, except for look at that hill. It wouldn't seem like much if you weren't in a car. But it is all-wheel drive, so that's good. Do not fear getting stuck exactly. I just fear anything touching the sides. And we have yet to find any reptiles hanging out.
Only rowdy teenagers. Is there a wall up there? That one looks a little difficult. Let's see how this one works out.
I have all the confidence in the world that that's going to turn and there's going to be plenty of room. I'm not going to get stuck.
Yeah, wasn't that bad.
I make it look easy, Ryan.
So does your mom.
Family show.
Dude, she bakes a mean. Wait, bakes a mean cheesecake. Makes it look easy.
She does.
What are you on about? Better have more respect for your mother.
I don't want to go left, and I don't. Oh, that made it.
Now we're in the whoop de whoops.
Oh, I don't like the scratches. Hopefully they're not really making scratches. Oh my goodness. And we were going closer to civilization here.
We're going back out.
And we're going back out into the middle of nothingness.
Oh boy. We turned away, guys. Still in the middle.
This one's going to be the rough one. Ooh, we made it. We made it. Going pretty good. Pretty excited. John, if you're watching, thank you for the tip. We have, oh man, it's getting tight.
Oh yeah, that is tight. Oh, you got it, you're good.
It's not that we're not, I just don't want it to scratch the car. If I didn't want it to scratch the car, I guess I shouldn't come down a dirt path in the middle of the woods. I really thought it was gonna end somewhere.
It is.
Yeah, with me going to the paint shop.
We need to get an R&B Reptiles wrap anyway.
On my car.